China is carrying out a demographic genocide in Xinjiang, and the birth rate of Uyghurs has declined drastically. The Chinese government is using draconian measures to curb birth rates among Uyghur Muslims, a Turkic-speaking minority who make up about 8 million of the 19 million population of the far western province of Xinjiang. This is part of China's Hanification policy, as Beijing is encouraging the Hans to procreate more children. The Chinese state is getting too intrusive. Hundreds of thousands of Uyghur women are subjected to regular pregnancy checks, forced intrauterine devices, involuntary sterilization, and even unconsented abortions. IUDs and sterilizations have fallen throughout China but have increased sharply among Uyghurs. According to the Associated Press, birth rates in the mostly Uyghur regions of Khotan and Kashgar plunged by more than 60% from 2015 to 2018, the latest year available in government statistics. Across the Xinjiang region, birth rates continue to plummet, falling nearly 24% last year alone, compared to just 4.2% nationwide, statistics show. The decline in the Uyghur birth rates is going to be unmatched, and Beijing is quite literally considering the possibility of obliterating an entire ethnic community from the face of the earth. The unprecedented level of forced birth control among Uyghur Muslims has led to experts calling the Chinese actions a form of demographic genocide. China's forced population control measures against the Uyghur women are backed by mass detentions and detention camps. People are sent to detention camps for having too many children. As per the Associated Press report, parents of three or more children are forced to separate from their families unless they can shell out exorbitant fines. Chinese police personnel raid homes and terrorize parents at will as they search for hidden children. The detention camps themselves are centers of brutal human rights violations. Chinese authorities call them re-education camps. The Uyghur Muslims are asked to swear allegiance to the Communist Party and forswear their Muslim faith. They are told to repeat that Islam is stupid. Within Xinjiang, Chinese authorities treat Islam as a mental disease. Thus, in internment camps, Uyghur Muslims are forced to criticize Islamic beliefs and sing communist propaganda songs for several hours. At the same time, they are forced to consume pork and alcohol, both of which are forbidden in Islam. What happens to Uyghur women while their husbands are detained in internment camps? They are forced to share beds with male Chinese officials, effectively converting the Uyghurs into concubines. The communist state of China has literally entered the Uyghur homes, blurring the difference between public and private space. Experts believe that China has deployed over 1 million spies to keep an eye on the Uyghur people. Uyghurs are mandated to invite government officials into their homes, provide them information about their lives and political views, and comply with political indoctrination. The Chinese administration has introduced the Pair Up and Become Family program, which involves the country's Han ethnic majority officers to stay in Uyghur households every 2 months as a part of the program. The institutions of family and marital bonds are being targeted in Xinjiang. Beijing doesn't want a single Uyghur family in the region, as Han majority officials have been labeled relatives of the monitored families by the Jinping regime. Also, mosques have either been razed or converted into propaganda centers by the Chinese authorities. Mosques in Xinjiang have been instructed to remove the holiest Islamic verse, "There is no God but God and Muhammad is the messenger of God." They are now replaced with red propaganda banners that read "Love the party, love the country" in yellow writing. There have been reports of a rather recent phenomenon of concerted persecution and medical testing among the Uyghurs. Last year, activist lawyer Hamid Sabi told the UN Human Rights Council that China is harvesting and selling organs from persecuted ethnic and religious minorities, including the Uyghur Muslims. China has also passed a law to sinicize Islam, a move aimed at the Uyghur Muslims. Xinjiang is geoculturally not a part of China, and Uyghurs are not Chinese. They are linguistically, ethnically, and religiously different from the communist state of China. Xinjiang is actually a part of the Turkestan region. In fact, it was briefly declared as an independent East Turkestan state, but was soon occupied by the communist regime of China. Ever since Beijing occupied Xinjiang, it has been trying to force Hanaification, which faced strong resentment among the Uyghurs.